I am the creator.
The creator of what?
The creator of all racing-based, family-themed entertainment. And since you found me, I suppose I must reveal my convoluted plan for world domination.
Oh, please don't.
You see, many years ago I was known as Chuck, a regular television executive bent on world domination.
Aren't they all?
I was the television executive that green-lit the original Wacky races. Afterwards, I had my brains removed and saved in this goo-filled tank, powered by draining the minds of people foolish enough to come to my park.
Why would you do that?
I was waiting. Waiting for the time when TV writers would run out of new ideas and be forced to reboot the Wacky races. All so I could gain access to the brain of Peter Perfect.
What Petey's brain exactly?
Because Peter is the star of the series.
Tiny thought he was the star.
Perfect's brain power.
You haven't actually watched any of the new episodes, have you?
Well, it's hard to find.
Come on! This was it. The final reel. The last act. The big wrap-up. All the answers I was after were at the end of that hall, and nothing was gonna stop me from getting them. What the? Old movies?
Wonderful. Marvelous. Beautiful, isn't it? Back when cartoons were funny and well-acted and not at all self-referential.
I hate that too.
Just random acts of pointless violence.
Hello?
Hi, everybody.
Excuse me, you never paid me.
What flavor popcorn is this?
O positive. I'll never let them take this smashing entertainment from me.
Aha! It's mine at long last.
There was still one thing I didn't understand.
Okay, I don't need any help for this part. There's still one thing I don't understand. Why do you want this silly old thing anyway?
Because I think the villain in it talks funny. I've hunted down and destroyed every copy of this calamitous cartoon, but this one. Now, I am going to eliminate the final...
You monster! You would destroy such sublime art!
Art? Oh, please, they pay monkeys to make this stuff.
We get paid.
From your episode, Cold Rush.
Haven't seen that one either, have you? Spending too much time on the internet. Complaining that the Anthill Mob wouldn't take a pay cut to work on the new series, aren't you, eh?
Destiny, be nice!
What an incredibly thin premise for a TV show. No wonder it feels like we've done these jokes before.
That's it! We quit!
Oh, that's Trey Cool. This movie is going to be retooled as a CG musical anyway. If you want to go back to your old racing show, that's starting up again.
It is? Why? The ratings were terrible.
Yeah, but it's easier than thinking up new ideas.
We're pleased as peace preserves you're back, Peter, darling, but I'm sorry about your show getting canceled.
Probably for the best.
Maybe it will get rebooted someday with a smaller mix of classic characters and fresh new faces.
Bring back a classic show without all the characters? Bleh, what an awful idea.
Maybe the writers could, bring a new absurdist self-referential tone to appeal to a younger, more media-savvy demographic.
They could update the designs to create a new line of toys.
Bah, a cheap ploy to make money. Audiences will see through that.
I guess some things are just better left as they were.
That's a wrap on the new Wacky Races series. Great job, everybody. Hey, did someone order my lunch?
What say you, Rasputin? Renowned prognosticator to the Tsar of Russia. What does the future hold for our band of Wacky Racers?
I see the Racers, starring in a cartoon in the 1960s with a creepy invisible narrator. Ragtime will be replaced by something called jazz. A strange new food called pizza will only be made well in Chicago. And the Racers cartoon will get a reboot in 2017, but no one will ever watch it.
Dear Uncle Dickie, as a person who has never met a child, I'm absolutely sure the excessive lowbrow violence on your show is inappropriate for younger viewers. Signed, an adult who still watches cartoons! Oh, please! If you were so concerned about children, you'd be reading one a dictionary right now, instead of letting the internet raise a generation of uncivilized urchins with attention spans so short children's shows have to constantly engage in the cheapest, most tasteless forms of sight gags and violence.
Boring.
Just to keep their interest.
I don't understand. Where was everybody?
They're all off watching reality TV shows that allow an emotionally cauterized generation to bask in the pain of sad, lonely people desperate for attention. That's why the shadowy elites who control programming at the Wacky Sports Networks, the Illuminati, have sent over a new development executive to spice up the show.
I'm back!
It's her, the crazy fan lady who wants to live in my blood.
You are the new development executive?
Me? Oh, no, no, no. What a crazy little bag of meat and gravy you are. I'm not interested in television. I'm just here to see my whittle-piddle-piddickian.
So, where is the new executive?
I gotta go sit. I got a meeting. Kisses.
You're just a mindless puppet. How are you qualified to run a television show?
Oh, wait, I may have just answered my own question.
Shall we get started? Does anyone need a water? Racers, I don't want you to think of me as some super powerful, tantrum-throwing, amoral studio executive who's here to completely change your show on some half-thought-out whim. I'm on your side. I love your show. I wouldn't change a thing.
Oh, that's very good to hear because we were very...
Yeah, we're changing everything.
Wow, big surprise.
But we're a race show.
You're a race show nobody watches.
Maybe, I don't know, if you advertised it more?
Or at all.
Well, as any television executive could tell you, the best way to appeal to a young audience looking for bold, fresh ideas is with familiar formula shows.
What does that...
Sitcom!
Is this hotel haunted by any chance?
There is no such thing as haunted hotels, silly.
It has all the usual accommodations. Inescapable maze garden, weeping walls, screaming closets, and basic cable.
Basic cable? No! Let's go in.
But what if there are ghosts in there? Terrible echoes of a horrible past best left forgotten.
Don't be silly. There are no such thing as ghosts.
And now, here they are.
Nah, animated shows never really pull off musical numbers.
I agree. You are the worst assistant ever! Ow! Oh! Ah! And you're hurting my hand!
What we need is something so simple that even an American audience can instantly grasp the concept.
Like racing.
Something with incredibly simple rules and pointless danger.
Like racing.
Something with cool cars we can make toys of.
He's going to say racing.
Something fast.
He's going to say racing.
Something furious.
He's going to say racing.
Something like...
Racing!
Like...
Racing!
Bowling!
What?
Nah, wait. Racing! I replaced you with younger drivers. This is television. What did you expect?
I hate this show.
I see. You just wasted 11 minutes of your life. And the Wacky Races will finally be on TV. But still, nobody will watch it.